Good afternoon.
Thank you.
And welcome to Our Lady of Hope. If you'd please rise.
Thank you. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, may no earthly undertaking hinder those who set out in haste to meet your Son, but may our learning of heavenly wisdom gain us admittance to his company, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort. Give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that her service is at an end. Her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out, "In the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in. Every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain. The rough country, a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom and leading the ewes with care." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years like one day. The Lord does not delay his promise, as some regard delay, but he is patient with you, not wishing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. The day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a mighty roar, and the elements will be dissolved by fire, and the earth and everything done on it will be found out. Since everything is to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you be? Conducting yourself in holiness and devotion, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be dissolved in flames and the elements melted by fire. But according to his promise, we await new heavens and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. Therefore, beloved, since you await these things, be eager to be found without spot or blemish before him at peace. The word of the Lord.
The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise.
afternoon. Advent is a special time for me because we were preparing to be ordained at this time. It was very disappointing a few years prior to hear that we were not being ordained in May, but the rationale from the diocese was that we would be ordained after we had served in parishes in our own diocese, which did make sense. So this is a very special season for me. And then thinking of preparing for priesthood, did they do a good job? Well, I guess yes, because I'm still here after 33 years, but there are many things we weren't prepared for, but many things to face what we were facing, we did prepare for by using old church techniques. And the first part of the spiritual life is that we have to acknowledge who we are, and that is that we are sinners, that nobody is blameless. And if we have an understanding of that, the rest will fall into place, like Thoreau's window in the cathedral. Jesus Christ is Lord, and from that, everything falls into place spiritually. But we have to understand that. We have to live that. That is why before each liturgy, we acknowledge our sins. Before we celebrate these sacred mysteries, let's clean the shelf a little bit. So what was John doing? He was, I guess they named a Toyota truck after him, the forerunner. And literally that's what he was. And sometimes the forerunner is different than the one to come after him. I always remember this funny little joke in Advent when we said goodbye to Bishop Wenske as he was coming down to Miami, going down to Miami, and we were awaiting a new bishop. And so we still gathered as priests and we had our convocation, but yet we had no bishop. So Father Tom Barrett, who was up at St. Brendan's, as we were coming into the room and he knew each of us as we were ordained in the same amount of years, he was saying to us, "Are you he who is to come, or should we look for another?" It's a very, very, very good quote. In those days, they were expecting a Messiah. There was buzz about the town. And so they literally asked that question to John. Are you the real deal? Are you he who is to come? Or should we look for another? And John said what he was, a forerunner. I am a voice crying in the desert saying, hey guys, we need to change. And literally that's what repent means, change. Change your heart, change your mind, change things all the time. It's not like we are, oh, I was baptized in 1985, I'm done. No. When the people came to John, they were baptized, and they were saying, I want to change, I'm accepting this gesture. And they did. But John even gave them a warning. Hey, listen, this was nice, but there is one who's coming after me, and I'm not worthy even to untie his sandals. I baptize you with water. He's going to baptize you with water and the Holy Spirit. Look out for that. And even what John did after he baptized Jesus, he said, go, there is the Lamb of God. I must decrease while he must increase. And so that was back then. What are we doing now? Well, we are preparing for this Advent season to celebrate Christmas. And it is good, not just in the commercial sense, are you ready for Christmas? But are you going to be ready for Christmas? Are you going to be ready for the true appreciation of what God has given to us? Or are we just going to be in a commercial haze, running around, oh, I did this, I did that, I got the lights off. How's that doing? You've missed the complete preparation of the season. Not that we can't have Christmas parties, etc., but are we preparing truly for Christmas? And are we preparing for Christ who is to come again? So baptism is the first step. Baptism is when we are clean, if you will, we take our glasses off and we hold them up to the true light of Christ. We don't compare ourselves to anyone else, to the true light of Christ, because we might say up here, hey, I'm spongeless, I got it back, I have no problem. But when we hold our vision to the true light, oops, I got a couple of smudges here. I need to go to confession. I need to get right with God. Because as you get older, you say, oh, time flies. I thought I was in my 40s, now I'm in my 70s. Well, time does fly. And he will be here like a thief in the night. And we don't know. But we shouldn't be worried about, in a sense, the cosmic. Our own individual world could end today. I mean, by actuarial science, I pretty much can guarantee you I'll be here at 7:30 to celebrate Mass tomorrow. But I don't firmly know that. That's why we live in vigilance. That's why we live in preparation. But when we are prepared, when things happen, we are ready to deal with them. So we are preparing for a very important visitor. And so if an important visitor is coming, we usually clean up, we make sure everything's in order and so forth, so that the visit goes very well. The person who is to come finds us ready. In January, we're going to be receiving the bishop who is confirming our young men and women in confirmation. Everybody goes through that preparation, but we want the celebration to go well. We want our lives to go well when we are prepared to meet the Lord. We are preparing for other things, and then we find ourselves in the midst of the pandemic. We shut down, we came together, we're going through things a little bit at a time. It may be bumpy, but we will be prepared to deal with this as we go through the seasons. We were preparing to receive new worship aids. Thank God they're working now. It's not up to the full use that we would desire, but it'll be a little bit bumpy, but it will be a major enhancement. That's what preparation is about. That's what spiritual patience is about. That's what not blaming others immediately is about. We are preparing our hearts, preparing to receive the Lord, not only this year, but for years to come. So that truly, when the entire world changes its focus and has more concern for the poor and the needy, has more concern for others just than for ourselves, it's a good thing. And the world becomes a little bit lighter. Again, as we prepare for this season for Advent, we not only prepare for ourselves, but we prepare for our world, and that we are all ready to receive him into our hearts. We stand now and profess our faith. I believe in
God, the Father Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten of not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things are made. For us, then, for salvation, he came down from heaven.
of the great things the Lord has done for us is to hear and answer our prayers. Filled with confidence and joy, we pray as one family.
Our response is, God of salvation, hear us. For all who lead and serve God's people, may they do so with sensitivity and vigor, we pray. God of salvation, hear us. For all Christian churches, that we may heed the herald's voice in the desert to prepare ye the way of the Lord, we pray. God of salvation, hear us. For the safety of all men and women currently serving in our military, and for true peace in a troubled world, we pray. God of salvation, hear us. In remembrance of National Pearl Harbor Day, as we recall the events and honor all those who died in the attack on Pearl Harbor on December 7, 1941, we pray. God of salvation, hear us. For all who are combating the coronavirus, that God will bring healing to the sick, strength to their caregivers, and wisdom to those researching cures, we pray. God of salvation, hear us. For all the lonely and the sick, especially Marianne Petrus, Dolores Jacklet, Pat DeLuke, Dr. Eugene White, and Joanna Masters, may they be comforted by Emmanuel, God with us, we pray. God of salvation, hear us. For all those who have died, especially James Kenny, Robert Johnson, and Dr. Jack Kim, may they be sharing in the kingdom of the Father, we pray. God of salvation, hear us. For Robert Leonard, who is being remembered in this Mass in a special way, we pray. God of salvation, hear us. And let us now pause at our own prayers and intentions. We pray. God of salvation, hear us.
Father, you call your people to rejoice at the coming of your Son. Make our joy complete as you grant our petitions. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Pray with me, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble sacrifice, prayers, and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and open for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hold. And so, with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end. We acclaim. So that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may the same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed it, and broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, taking the chalice that was filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and to hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a few announcements. Just as a reminder of the Feast of the Immaculate Conception, we will be following the regular Holy Day schedule. I have a vigil at 7 p.m. the evening before, Mass at the day proper at 8:30, and at 7 p.m. Just to be aware that the Holy Day is there on the 8th. Also, please return any angel gifts that you have by December 13th, and thank you for everyone who participated in this program. We are out of Sunday missals for 2021 at this time. We should be receiving more by next weekend. And again, entry is limited to one person at a time. Also, next Sunday, December 13th, we will be having a blood drive from 8 to 1 p.m. Also, we have penance services scheduled for the 12th and the 17th, and we will be letting you know those times for the services. And we will also give you information for other churches in the area as well. With COVID, things are a little bit different. We are going to have services. They will be briefer, and we will have priests so that the assembly may come and go after the confession is heard. And we're trying to do this as safely and as quickly as possible. For the remainder of the announcements, please look at our website at Our Lady of Hope. Are there any birthdays this?
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord.